everybody, it's Leroy from Canon Light Digital TV, LUX.INVIDIA, and I am here with my 60D and two Canon lenses, one being the 1.4 and the other being the 1.2. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is because there is a roughly over $1,000 price difference between the two, and so I wanted to see what the difference was between the two lenses. Now, if you're anything like me, it's just out of mere curiosity. This one, this little tiny one, this little baby 1.4 is my lens, so 1.2 is a borrowed lens. Now, I barely got them. I haven't had done any tests. I haven't taken any photos, any video with them. So I'm going to be learning along with you on this. So this is not really a technical type of review. It's more of like a show and tell. So hopefully you guys get to see the difference between the two, but hopefully you can see the difference. Okay, let's get down to it. Cheers. All right, before we get started, a couple things I want to show you guys. Now, the 1.2 has a 72 millimeter filter thread, and right away you can see just how big that aperture is. I mean, look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Huge. I do love that a lot. That is like super awesome. I could put it on this lens probably and just like film like that. Ooh, that's a pretty good idea. That's scary. No, but really, it's really, really like ginormous. And now we compare it with mine, the 1.4, and you could just kind of see a difference like right away. Look at that. So you're going to get a lot more light. Mine's dirty. It has a fingerprint on it. Anyways, but I just wanted to show you that before we get started. Oh yeah, and the 1.4 has a 58 millimeter filter thread, which is nice too, but not as nice as that. All right, guys, so here we go again. We have the 1.2 50 millimeter lens, and this is just a depth of field, it's not really a test, more of a demo than anything else. But we're gonna start with the foreground and we're gonna roll it back to the background, okay? So here we have a little chess set in front of us, and let's see, that leaves sharper. That's about as sharp as I could see it from my finder right here. All right, so we're just gonna roll it back, okay? We're gonna do it slowly so you get the idea how much depth of field this guy really has. There's a 50 millimeter right there. I'm gonna keep rolling it. 2470, Canon cleaning solution. That right there is a glass head. And we're gonna roll it to the background. There we go. And now let's roll it back. There we go. Let's get a little different angle this time. Let's start over here. Got this dusty old chess that I never play. All right, let's actually get the pawn. And then let's get that focus so you see that little hair of dust on it. I never play. Anyways, now we're gonna roll it back to the background again. And here we go. Now this probably isn't the best one. Let's just move it again. Let's just move it back to this one because the angle isn't right. And I want to keep the same because I want to change lenses. So here we go again. The light is kind of throwing me off a little bit. Looks about sharp right there. Okay, now we're gonna roll it back. That head again, and all the way to the background. It looks about right. I'll roll it back to the front. Sweet. And that is the 50 millimeter 1.2 lens, okay? Now we're going to switch lenses. So here we are, we're in the foreground. Now we're going to roll it to the background just like we did before. Now, I can already see it doesn't look as, it's good. There we go, the head and the background. So looks like I'm slightly different. So let's do it again. Go to the front. So here we are. So again, this is 1.4, 100 ISO, 1.4 f-stop, 100 ISO, and 200 shutter speed. I had to bring it up a bit because, like I told you, it doesn't bring in as much light. So here we go. So I slow down the shutter speed. Now we're going to roll it, the focus to the background. There we go. And then we're going to bring it back to the front. Boom. Now let's just change the angle just a little bit. Let's see here. It's a little too close. Well, let's just go back over here. There we go again. And I'm going fast with the focus ring because mine's just a little bit looser, actually a lot looser. So I'm not struggling trying to keep it steady as much. Like I said, I do everything manual. So when I'm actually doing this, I'm just using one finger to do the focus. Right now I'm using both just because I'm trying to keep it more steady. But you know, when you're in the field, when I'm in the field, I just use my middle finger. So I'm usually holding it, the viewfinder, or holding it on the side, and then diddling it. There you go, one more time. And there it is. Boom. That's sharp enough? Right there. All right, guys, well, that kind of concludes my test. Using the 1.4 and the 1.2, I wasn't really entirely impressed. I don't think it's worth that $1,000 difference. That's just my opinion. You know, for those of you who have lots of money and just want to spend on more gear, by all means, I think it'll work for you. Personally, it's okay for me.